December 28, 2005, I'm teaching the intern from Melbourne U how to handle a fierce cat. Now, this fierce cat was transported here in a cage, in a carrier. So there are two ways of sedating him for the cleaning of the ears. Now, the first method is, of course, put this carrier inside a big black plastic bag and pass the isoflurane gas in and wait maybe 10-15 minutes. And that will do when the cat sleeps, and then take it out and continue with the mask. That's what we are doing now. Now, the second method I teach him is to hold the carrier upside down. Hold the carrier upside down. Of course, this door is closed. This door is closed. Yeah, this door is closed. Yeah. It's already not, make sure it's locked, and then hold the carrier upwards, up vertically, up and down, and the cat's backside will drop onto, up some more, and the cat's backside will drop onto here. So then the vet will inject the muscle, the back muscle, and with sedative thalazine ketamine, in this case of 0.1, 0.4, and then you find that the cat is down, sedated. So in this case, after sedation, you can see if we need to, we use gas. If we don't need to, then we will straight go into the ear irrigation. Then ear irrigation, and then take the turn, and then the right ear, the complaints, the right ear is full of pus. So right ear, so pull up the ear tip, and then ear 45 degrees to the ear canal. Right hand, of course. Left handed, right handed.
Right.
Okay, then 45 degrees in. Squirt in.
Squirt.
A bit faster than that. To clear the pus. Okay, so continue. I see the debris coming out. Okay, so take the thing over here. Take the container as close as possible. You know the cat is down already. With some sniff of the isoflurane, so that's enough. You don't give too much because there was sedation. So fast on, it's too slow, so nothing much comes out.
It's so like really fast, okay.
Correct, you see more come out now. Now this cat went out and then came back with this pass. Okay, let's fill up two syringes first. Fill up. We need the big CC one, the 20 CC will do. Fill up two, I will demonstrate. Yeah. Fill up two, then I will demonstrate. Okay, you come this side first. So he'll come this side to video how I do. No, they come. Okay. Zoom in if possible.
Okay.
Hold copy.
Okay.
Go around in that better.
Sure.
Don't drop. Okay, so I will just demonstrate. Now. Ear irrigation in dog or cats is the same. Now you can see that this is really bad. You see the blood, everything is here. Okay. And so, first of all, I will remove a bit of the debris first. Yeah. Remove as much as I can. As much as I can. All these are inside. Okay, so now I'm going to show how I'm going to irrigate the ears. Okay. Now, 45 degrees to the vertical canal. Massage.
Oh, okay.
Then one more time. Sometimes if it is really shoot up in the place. But that's the best way. Now, there are some vets who prefer to use the ear drops and all this to liquefy and dissolve the wax. But I find that this is still the best way, because whatever ear drop you put in, it just drop into the horizontal canal and it may not even get it up. Although you can use eardrops, commercial eardrops or veteran eardrops and do it, and then you just put it in. That's what I'm syringing in, and then you just use cotton wool and try and get it up. Yeah. Okay, so one more time. Normally I do about 10 times. So about 45 degrees. so that the thing will come up. That's why the owner can't do it because of the cat is doesn't cooperate. Okay, normally do 10 syringes and 20 cc will be better. But you can do 10 cc, but it's not so powerful. As you can see, the sedation is much better than using the isoflurane gas alone. But the one is short acting. So you see one more time. See the canal is here. This is the vertical canal, that's the vertical canal. So you aim for the vertical canal. Because it goes to the horizontal. So if you don't do a proper job, you just can't get it. About probably you prepare 10 syringes or 5 syringes, then you don't need to keep on filling up. Then you got to massage quite hard to dislodge any more ulcers, which you can see there is some ulcers here there. No need to go so near, you can zoom actually. There is some, well, there's an ulcer here, a white spot here there. That could be the ulcer or the bleeding spot or the pus. Okay, so I'm going to let him do what you're going to do now.
Yeah.
Look at some.
Okay.